This is Italian Football Lover Channel, my friends. Roma-Inter game was ended 2-2 draw. I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. Just I want to start with Roma's tactics. In Roma played in 3-4-3 formation. I write Roma's players and just the numbers of Inter players these are. In Roma, sometimes Veretout come to the center of the defense next to the Smalling. Veretout came to here, and Mancini and Ibanez came close to midfield line. And in Roma, Villar and Veretout played close to each other, and in Roma attacks, Edin Dzeko sometimes came to left wing and Mkhitaryan came to middle here. They changed their positions between each other, and Pellegrini came from the right and he came inside like this. For example, in Roma's goal, Dzeko came to left and he gave his pass to Mkhitaryan, and Pellegrini came from the right and scored the goal, the Roma's goal. And in Roma attacks, sometimes and Dzeko and Mkhitaryan came to central forward together, and Spinazzola and Karstorp came forward. They made the forward four, and Pellegrini played behind of Dzeko and Mkhitaryan. Sometimes Pellegrini came here, back of Dzeko and Mkhitaryan, Spinazzola and Karstorp came to forward in Roma. And in the second half, Inter start to play better in the second half. They made so much pressure on Roma. In the second half, Roma's left wing was so weak. The left wing Ibanez and Spinazzola. This wing was so weak. Inter developed so dangerous attacks from the right with Hakimi against Roma. But after Paolo Fonseca made substitution, Spinazzola out, Perez in, because left wing was so weak. And after Veretout out and Cristante in, this substitution made Roma midfield stronger, and Cristante played more offensively. He played close to Dzeko, Pellegrini and Mkhitaryan, and Villar played more defensively in balance, and Roma played better to the end of the game. They made pressure on Inter defense. At the same time, Mancini, Smalling and Ibanez, these three came close to midfield together, and Villar played close to these three, and Cristante, Pellegrini supported the attacks, and Karstorp and Bruno Perez came from the wings, and they together supported the attacks, and sometimes Mkhitaryan got into the box, and sometimes Karstorp came close to the right line, and Pellegrini came to inside, came to middle, and got into the penalty area. Pellegrini made so good passes, and the game was finished 2-2. And secondly, I want to talk about Inter's tactics. Inter played in 3-5-2 formation. I write Inter's players and just Roma's players' numbers here. In Inter, and Brozovic sometimes came between the defense line. He came back center of the defense, and Skriniar and Bastoni came to midfield from the wings together, and Barella made pressure on Ibanez, and at the same time Veretout. there is between bilateral struggles with Veretout and Barella on the midfield. And Lautaro Martinez made press on Mancini. Lukaku made press on Smalling. There were so many bilateral struggles between Smalling and Romelu Lukaku. And at the same time, Lukaku came back and got the ball. He helped the midfield and he opened empty spaces for Hakimi. Hakimi came to forward and supported the attacks, and Lukaku opened empty spaces for Hakimi, and Lautaro found goal positions for Inter in the first half. And at the same time, Darmian was injured and Young replaced of him. And Inter started the second half better and faster. Lukaku and Lautaro together came back to midfield, got the balls, and especially Lukaku started the attacks for Inter. And in the second half, Hakimi played so effective, and Hakimi and Lukaku played close to each other, and they played together so effective, and right wing of Inter was so strong in the second half offensively. And for example, in the second goal of Inter, Hakimi scored the goal, and two more substitution made by Antonio Conte. Arturo Vidal was little bit injured. Gagliardini replaced of him. Gagliardini played here. And Hakimi out. Kolarov in. After these substitutions, Ashley Young played on the right. Young played on the right. Kolarov played here on the left instead of Ashley Young. Kolarov. And but Roma made so much pressure to end of the game, and especially Mkhitaryan, sometimes Mkhitaryan came inside and got into the box, and sometimes Pellegrini got into the box of Inter, and Pellegrini made press on Bastoni, and Dzeko made press on De Vrij. But it was so balanced game for these two teams. They deserved this draw result. And all my comments like this, you can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Please open up your notification rings, notification bells, and you can write your comments and suggestions under my video. Thank you very much, and see you on my next videos. Bye.